Hello students, I am Vidya from GK Jain School. Now I am going to teach you about measurement from class 7. What is measurement? What are the importance of this measurement in our day to day life? Let's see. What is measurement? The measurement is determination of size and quantity of the substance by comparing it with unknown quantity. That means the comparison of unknown quantity with known quantity. Right? Let me say one example. See, this is dye. Now I want to find out what is the length of this dye. So this is unknown length. So that has been compared with known quantity, known length. This is a ruler, a contact measurement. I just compared this, right? The dye. And what is the length of this dye? 21 centimeter. The length of the dye is 21 centimeter. So this is how we can do the measurement by comparing the unknown quantity with known quantity. Okay, understood. Now this is the physical quantity. What does mean by physical quantity? Physical quantities. The physical quantity is a property of a material or system that can be quantified by the measurement. The physical quantity means the material or system that can be quantified by measurement. Those things, those quantities are called as a physical quantities. We have quantified this thing. Okay, so this is the 121 centimeter. The length of this dye is 21 centimeter. Then this length, this comes under the physical quantity. Okay, now what is, how we can express this physical quantity in the magnitude? So this is what called as the magnitude of the physical quantity. The magnitude of the physical quantity can be expressed as value with unit. That means this 21 is value. And centimeter, this is unit. So the magnitude of the physical quantity can be expressed as value with unit. Understood? So this physical quantity can be classified into two. So before going into this classification, we have to know what are the examples. Okay, some examples for this physical quantity: mass, distance, temperature, volume, weight. So all those things are comes under the physical quantity, and those result can be expressed as a magnitude like this. Now we come to the classification. What are the classification of this physical quantity? One is a fundamental quantity and another one is a derived quantity. What is mean by fundamental quantity? The quantities which cannot be expressed in terms of other quantities are called as a fundamental quantity. The same thing. So the same example I have taken here. See, this is the dye. And how we find out that result? What is the length of this dye? I just compared with this ruler. Okay, I measured directly with this ruler by using this ruler. I didn't do any calculation to find out what is the length of this dye. So it comes under the fundamental quantity. I didn't express in terms of other quantities, right? What is mean by, I hope now you can understand what is the fundamental quantity. For the fundamental quantity, we don't want to do any calculation. We can measure it directly with the help of the thing. That is the known quantities. Okay. There are seven fundamental quantities are there. And that magnitude can be expressed with the unit, that are SI units. First, we have to see what are those seven fundamental quantities: mass, length, time, temperature, amount of substance, electric current, luminous intensity. All those things all comes under the fundamental quantities. Let's see what are units, SI units for fundamental quantity. The unit of mass is kilogram. And the unit of length is meter. The unit of time is second. The unit of temperature is There are three different scale has been used to determine the temperature, but out of those three we have taken Kelvin scale as a SI unit for temperature. Amount of substance is mole and electric current is ampere, that can be denoted as A, symbol A. And luminous intensity, the unit of luminous intensity is candela, that is denoted as CD. So these are the seven fundamental quantities and the units. Okay, now we are going to see about what is derived quantities. It is quite opposite to the fundamental quantities. The quantities which can be expressed in terms of other quantities. For example, now I have to find out what is the volume of the diode. Okay, we have find out what is the length of the diode, that comes under the fundamental quantity. Now I am going to find out what is the volume of this diode. Okay, what is the volume formula? L into B into height. That means length into breadth and height. So now we are going to find out what is it. Already we have found what is the length of this diode, that is 21, and breadth of this diode. Okay, here. So this is the breadth. So that is 2 centimeter. And what is the height here? This is height. That is 15 centimeter. Now we have to do calculation. We have to multiply these three quantities. By doing the calculation, we can find what is the volume of this diode. Then this volume of the diode comes under the derived quantity, because the volume can be expressed in terms of other quantities like length, breadth and height. Let's do the calculation. 21 into 2. Okay, that is 2, 4, 42 into 15. So what is the result? 5 2 is 10, remaining 1, 20, 21, so 20, 210, and 2, 4. So the result is 4, 3, 6. 630 centimeter. What is the unit will be? See here, this is 1 centimeter and for the breadth is centimeter and height is centimeter. So when we multiply these 3 centimeter, what will be the unit for volume? Centimeter cube. So this is how we can obtain the result for the derived quantity by doing the calculation like multiplication and division. So if you want to find out what is the density of this diode, means the formula for the find out density, density that is mass divided by volume. So for that density, first you have to find out what is the mass of the diode, and volume already we have find out. Okay, by doing that calculation of division, we can obtain what is the density of this diode. So by doing these things, okay, by doing the calculation, we can find out what is the measurement. Okay, what is the result of the derived quantities like volume, density, area, okay, force. So there are many derived quantities out there. Okay students, next video we will see detailed things regarding this derived quantities. I hope this video will be very useful for you all. If you want more updates on educational videos like this, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel GKJ. Thank you.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.